channel. My name is Shelby, and today I'm going to be doing a romance recommendation video, but instead of focusing on a trope, I'm going to be doing, if you liked this book, you will like this book. I did a poll over on my Instagram last week asking what kind of videos you guys were interested in, and someone replied that they love these types of videos, so I figured I would do one. I'm going to be focusing on 5 books that are a little bit more popular, and I'm going to talk about 5 books that maybe are a little less popular that you might not have heard of. As always, I will link them all down below, and let's get right into it. So the first book I'm going to be giving a recommendation for is Hate Notes by Vi Keeland and Penelope Ward. This one is actually pretty popular. It is an office romance, enemies to lovers. It's about a boss and his assistant or his employee. And the one I'm going to be recommending is one I just recently read, and that is Right Where I Want You by Jessica Hawkins. The premise is a little bit different in this one. It's about a guy who works for this company, and his company brings in a consultant to help fix the magazine, and the consultant is the heroine. And so they are butting heads a lot. It is definitely enemies to lovers. And like with Hate Notes, it has a lot of comedic aspects to it, but both of the stories do have a lot of deeper and more emotional elements, which I really liked in both of them and made me really connect to them. If you love Hate Notes, I think you're gonna love Right Where I Want You, especially if you love enemies to lovers office romances. I also recently read Full Tilt by Emma Scott, and this one is quite a popular book. A lot of people have recommended it to me. If you don't know what it is about two people who have a chance encounter meeting. The heroine is a guitar player in a famous band, and the hero is her limo driver, and he has a heart condition. He had a heart transplant a couple years ago, so he does have a chronic illness, and it is their romance. It is very, very emotional. And when I read this, it made me think a lot of A Thousand Boy Kisses by Tilly Cole. This one might have come out around the same time as Full Tilt, but I don't hear near enough people talk about it. It is also a kind of friends to lovers romance, but the characters in this story are a lot younger. They are in high school versus Full Tilt is new adult. But because Tilly Cole normally writes adult romances, it doesn't feel like YA whatsoever. It's also about someone with a chronic illness, and it is a very emotional story as well. Both of these books had me sobbing, and while the premises of these books are a little bit different, I felt very similarly when I read them. And so I think if you really enjoyed Full Tilt, you are going to love Tilly Cole's A Thousand Boy Kisses. The next one I have is an oldie but a goodie, and that is The Edge of Never by J.A. Redmersky. This is a new adult romance that blew up years ago, and I haven't really heard people talk about it since, but I really enjoyed it when I first read it. It is a super angsty new adult romance about two people that I believe are road tripping together, and I think they are both musicians and they go on stage together. And the one that I have to recommend is On the Way to You by Candy Steiner. This is also a new adult angsty romance about two people who go on a road trip together. And like with The Edge of Never, On the Way to You, both characters are dealing with some really serious things in their personal life. The road tripping elements are very similar, but what I like about both of them is the super angsty elements. You definitely could tell it is a new adult romance, and what I like is they are new adult, but they aren't college new adult. And sometimes I feel like it's hard to find a good new adult book that doesn't take place in college. And I feel like On the Way to You by Candy Steiner is her most underrated standalone novel. Anytime anyone asks me what I recommend by this author, I recommend this one because I don't hear enough people talk about it. And then a super popular traditionally published romance is Josh and Hazel's Guide to Not Dating by Christina Lauren. This book is pretty hit or miss for people, but I thought it was really cute. It is a friends to lovers romantic comedy about two friends who end up setting each other up on blind dates, and none of the blind dates work out, so after each date they end up hanging out together, and it is their romance. And what I have to recommend is A Piece of My Heart by Tegan Hunter. You guys know I love this series. I think Tegan Hunter writes really good romantic comedies, and this is also a friends to lovers romance, but the two people did know each other when they were kids, whereas Josh and Hazel met as adults. But what's kind of similar in the plot is that the hero starts going on blind dates in the pizza parlor where the heroine works. So she keeps seeing him go on dates and they all go really poorly. And so she ends up going on dates with him to kind of help him practice. And so the premise that way is kind of similar. I really loved A Piece of My Heart. I think I loved it even more than Josh and Hazel's Guide to Not Dating. And if you haven't checked out this series already, I think you definitely should. The last one that I have is A Love Letter to Whiskey by Candy Steiner. This is an extremely angsty book. I think a lot of people think of this book when they think of something angsty. It is a new adult college romance. It isn't my favorite by Candy Steiner, but it definitely is a lot of people's favorites. So I feel like a lot of people are looking for similar books that give them the same feels. And the one that reminded me a lot of it in terms of angst is Drive by Kate Stewart. I recently read this one and I absolutely loved it. It is also a new adult college aged romance full of angst, but the premise is a little bit different. In A Love Letter to Whiskey, I believe there's only the hero and heroine, and it's kind of the will they or won't they give and take the whole story, versus Drive is a love triangle. So there's the heroine and two different heroes, and she ends up picking marrying one of them in the end, but it is a lot of give and take and will they or won't they, and definitely a lot of angst there because it is a love triangle. Like with a love letter to Whiskey, you get so angry with the characters in Drive because you just get so frustrated with all the angstiness. Both of them do have a lot of emotion to them, so if you're looking for a somewhat emotional read as well, I think you would really enjoy it. So those are 5 recommendations I have for you guys based on 5 popular books. I'd love to hear if you've read any of these books and if you liked them. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys on my next one. Bye.